On the 12th of February 1989, Pat Finnegan, an Irish lawyer in Belfast, sat at his kitchen table to have dinner with his wife and three children. As they ate, two gunmen burst through the door. They entered the room and shot Mr. Finnegan 14 times. He was killed by a loyalist paramilitary group that then, as the Prime Minister at the time, David Cameron, admitted in 2011, was acting in complicity with British security services. Far from stopping Mr. Finnegan's murder, the Prime Minister described, and I quote, the shocking levels of state collusion in Mr. Finnegan's murder. His family are still owed a public inquiry into the murder. Deeply troubling acts of state agents like the Finnegan case are not isolated. In 2010, it came to light that for 40 years, Britain's police had run covert operations spying on thousands of civilians. More than 1,000 political groups were spied on. Overwhelmingly, it was left-wing, anti-racist and climate justice groups that were spied on, with just three far-right groups included on the list. The Sky Cops revelations have shown that police operatives deceived women into sexual relationships and that even spying on grieving families seeking justice, including the parents of Stephen Lawrence. Madam Deputy Speaker, this bill must be opposed. It places no limits on the crimes that state agents can be authorised to commit. It doesn't prohibit torture, it doesn't prohibit murder, it doesn't prohibit sexual violence. Instead, all it requires is that authorising officers themselves believe the conduct is appropriate, that is necessary by broadly defined criteria, and that it meets requirements that might be imposed by an order by the Secretary of State. Even the FBI expressly bans operatives from certain criminal conduct. But this bill doesn't ban any type of criminal conduct for British state agents. And the grounds upon which the authorisations can be granted are ill-defined and wide-ranging. Not just national security, but also, and I quote, to prevent disorder and to promote the interests of the economic well-being of the United Kingdom. This has rightly raised alarm bells from trade unions like my union, Unite, and justice campaigns like the All Grieve Truth and Justice campaign, who fear that these powers could be used to interfere with the legitimate activities of trade unions. And the bill grants these powers to a dizzying array of agencies, not just intelligence agencies and the police, but the Competition and Markets Authority, the Gambling Commission, and the Environment Agency, just to name a few. The oversight for authorisation of potentially serious crimes is scandalously weak. There are no provisions in this bill for warrants or independent judicial approval. Instead, authorisation would be granted internally. This means that incredibly serious crimes could be authorised with less oversight than what is currently required for phone tapping or police searches. And Madam Deputy Speaker, as the human rights group Reprieve have noted, survivors of the Sky Cop scandal have sought justice through the courts for abuses that they suffered. But this bill will block future claims being brought forward since it outlaws civil action against authorised activities. This is utterly unconscionable. Madam Deputy Speaker, in the bill's defence, the government claims that public authorities are bound by the Human Rights Act. And for that reason, the prohibition against crimes like torture are guarded against. But in reality, this offers no protection against agent criminality because, in the government's view, the Human Rights Act does not apply to crimes committed by covert agents. As the government told the Investigatory Powers Tribunal in November 2019 in tasking agents, and again, I quote, the state is not the instigator of that activity and cannot be treated as somehow responsible for it. According to the government's own standards, therefore, the bill would not place any limits on the crimes agents could be authorised to commit. Not to torture, not to murder, not to sexual violence. I must progress. Madam Deputy Speaker, this bill marks the latest step in a frightening descent into a growing authoritarianism coming from this government. In the past 2 weeks, it has proposed the effective decriminalisation of torture for British soldiers overseas, the shipping of asylum seekers more than 4,000 miles away to be imprisoned on Ascension Island, the ban on anti-capitalist teaching materials in schools, and now this, licensing undercover agents to commit torture, sexual violence and murder. Madam Deputy Speaker, this descent into authoritarianism should be a concern to us all. It must be resisted.